Dear Mr. De Kemp, Mr. Coleman, lieber Herr Krötschel, lieber Herr Koch, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for the warm welcome and the opportunity to speak at this event, which deals with one of the hottest topics in the world of science policy. In the context of the digital transformation, open science became one of the leading topics of national and international science policies. With regard to the EU, we can see this in projects such as the European Open Science Policy Platform, the Open Science Monitor, the European Open Science Cloud, and several other activities. For the Berlin universities and the research institutions, the Berlin Senate in 2015 passed the Open Access Strategy for Berlin. It aims for free accessibility and comprehensive usability of scientific publications, research data, and cultural heritage. A key element of open science is the claim for openness of digital research and teaching. This means that research results, research data, research methods and procedures, as well as course and teaching content, software and tools are available free of charge and can be reused. Following the open science approach aims for improving disciplinary and interdisciplinary cooperation as well as low-threshold forms of knowledge and technology transfer, including citizen science. Open science does not only concern changes in research and teaching processes. It also impacts funding, governance, collaboration, and standardization processes. These fields will be addressed in the preparation of the Berlin University Alliance. Open science is without doubt closely related to the digital transformation of science and infrastructures. These will enable new forms of research and collaboration as well as new options to distribute text publications, databases, multimedia objects, etc. In the context of digitalization, openness has to be understood in an extended meaning as a paradigm of open access demonstrates. In principle, it is the scientific version of self-publishing, which as a rule includes quality management procedures, such as peer reviewing in particular, and takes place with infrastructural support of libraries and or publishers by the authors themselves. The existing technology makes it possible for researchers to manage the publication process independent of publishers and to design it to their own discretion. Although we can't go into too many details here, I would like to point out two trends that are essential for the understanding of the extended meaning of openness. The first is the availability of the publications. The second is the financing and its effects. Open access publications must be discoverable, readable, and/or usable, and sustainably available. In order to meet these standard requirements for scientific publication, open access publications are recorded according a common metadata standard. They are presented by PDF, HTML or other formats and stored on repositories of libraries and or publishers or permanently and are permanently available there. These standardization helps to secure free access on the basis of Creative Commons, common licenses as well as long-term availability. The second trend of open access is the new funding model. Funding is no longer reader-based or usage-based, based on subscription, by publication, based on the basis of article processing charges. In the long run, this will lead to a change of responsibilities. Libraries will continue to inform about APC publications and monitor OA publications. Funding of the publication-based text might, however, move over the authors. Under these circumstances, the libraries would no longer be in charge of the publication budget. This can be viewed as a starting point for a new ecosystem of scientific publishing and, at the same time, of literature and information provisioning, as well as future cooperation between authors and infrastructures. The new roles and tasks might look as follows. The traditional publishers focus on organizational and technical services of the publication process, such as production of publications, storage of repositories, and marketing, including indexing. The peer-reviewed process could also remain a task of the publishing houses. It could, however, also be transferred to a scientific community or universities. The brands of the traditional publishing houses will, in any case, continue to play an important role. New open access publishers enter the competition for customers and market shares. They will try to gain influence by price of article fees, by openness for the open peer reviewing process, or by the performance of the publications. Publishing initiatives are also increasingly being taken up by specialists, communities, or universities, as well as academic libraries. These initiatives seem at the forefront of experimenting with new forms of publication based on digital or virtual work and research environments. The brief overview of open access makes clear that these developments are driven rather dynamically. In context with the economic impact, which cannot yet be conclusively analyzed and assessed, a new ecosystem is emerging, which is heavily influenced by collaborative or shared economy approaches. The privacy linear value chain is developing more and more into a network of actors who are involved in scholarly communication. This also affects the usage of publications that can be contextualized and linked in completely new ways. What was said about open access is also true for open data. The extended significance of openness is based on the fact that research data management is even more immediately integrated into the work and research process than open access publishing. Let us take a look at which requirements and expectations are associated with open data and open data management. Two reasons for open data are the traceability of research results and the reuse of research data for new research projects. The prerequisites for this are findability, accessibility, and interoperability, which are combined in the so-called FAIR principles. As for open access, publication standards are also fundamental for the reusability of research data. Otherwise, it's not possible to fulfill and guarantee the FAIR principles. One key element for the traceability of research results are the reusability of research data is the availability of appropriate software. Therefore, data must be generated and processed using software that meets the requirements of open as well. under the heading Open Source Software Components, including documentation, are available on GitHub in order to be able to use and process open data as well as open available data publications on the software side. Open access and open data show that open science is entering a new ecosystem. As a result, existing governance structures are replaced by new participation and decision-making structures in the sense of a collaborative and sharing economy. Against the backdrop, the study knowledge exchange approach to open scholarship questions the following topics concerning financing, organization, and governance of open science. Evaluation and impact economy of academic goods from the perspectives of the society and the politics, the disciplines, and the individual researches. Incentives to increase scientific engagement, inclusion of the society, and reputation building. Funding of research and teaching, including the necessary developments and upgrades of infrastructure and services. Standardization to ensure collaboration between research and infrastructure, including measures for skilling. Public-private partnership for integrating open science into society and for monitoring the cooperation between public law research and the private sector. It becomes clear how many challenges have to be taken up to establish a governance model for open science. Open science will be one of the issues of the Berlin University Alliance. The four institutions, as you know, Freie Universität, Humboldt Universität, Technical University, and Charité, will connect to this international development of research and education linked to EU initiatives. The prerequisites for the implementation of open science are new governance structures for which initial approaches are available. Final solutions, however, do not yet exist. Johannes Vogel might further dive into this matter in his upcoming keynote. The institutions involved in the joint application of the Berlin University Alliance can significantly contribute to the further development of these approaches and at the same time benefit from international cooperation. By developing a new governance model of open science, suitable participation and decision-making structure will be established on the basis of the questions mentioned before. At the same time, effective measures for organizational development will be taken up to exploit the potential of open science and to design the cooperation within the Berlin University Alliance. This may the claim for excellence of the Berlin University Alliance can and will be integrated into the international context. Thank you very much for your attention, and I hope you will have a fruitful discussion in the next 2 days. Thank you so much.